We're gonna mount the hoses for the synchronization gauges on these nipples, one for each carburetor. Then we take the gauges and close these valves on every one. And this is to adjust the needle. If it's shivering too much, you close it. If it's not moving at all, you open it up a little bit. What we're gonna do now is connect each four of the gauges to only one carburetor and adjust each of them to the same. But let me explain first what you actually do when adjusting the synchronization. These set of carburetors have one single idler adjusting screw. And with that you adjust the idling speed of all four carburetors. But what if one carburetor to one cylinder is adjusted to a higher RPM than the others? Let's say three are adjusted to 1500 and one is adjusted to 2000 RPM. Then the engine is gonna run like crap, you know, because the one cylinder is like pulling the others. That's not good. And with these nipples, you can adjust the so-called vacuum behind the carburetor. And when it's adjusted to the same, you got the same RPM on all cylinders. That's what we're gonna do. And before starting the synchronization, we let the engine idle until it's hot. That's pretty important. Now only this gauge is hooked up and see what's doing. Now the needle is shivering. If I open more, it's shivering more. That's not what I want. I want to have it still. So I close the valve a little bit. Like this. And now I'm gonna do the same on all four. That's good. All four gauges are hooked up to all four carburetors. And what we're gonna do now is adjust all gauges to the same value with these little screws right there. You see the Phillips head? We got three of those screws. And what we do with that is adjust carburetor one and two to each other, three and four to each other, and then carburetor one and two to three and four. It's pretty important to know, because otherwise you will never get the good values. Because when turning that screw, you change two carburetors at a time. So that's pretty important to know. And now let's see what we got. Okay, you see? It's okay, but not good. And you even hear that when the bike is running. So we will start with this one. That's good enough. We mount these little plugs back on the nipples. And in case you're wondering what this hose is for, it's connected to the vacuum nipple of one carburetor, and it's on the other side it's connected to the fuel valve, and it actually activates the fuel valve. So fuel only comes out of this if the engine is running, but not in PRI mode. That's the prime mode, and that's to prime the carburetors. So remember, on prime, the fuel valve is always open, and on, it's only open if the bike's running. Hui. Hallo.